Morning, everybody. It's lovely to see us all gathered in. Just a few quick announcements just as we start today. We have, if you've noticed, just this week we put it out and it's out at the front. Ryan has done a wonderful job sorting out new flyers for the church, but I think this is a lovely picture. So if you notice the wee church and the Drumlins and then Belfast in the distance, but it's got the new church website address at the top of it. Okay, and if you want to find out what's on, you just flip the wee flyer over. We don't have them yet, but as you go out of the church, there's a QR code on the door. If you scan this QR code, right, does anybody know what a QR code is? It's that funny wee box thing at the top right hand corner. If you have a smartphone and you hold your smartphone up to the camera, but it takes you to the church website. So I've been dragged kicking and screaming into the technological age, as you should say, Ryan, is that right? Brilliant. It's far better and everything's there. But Ryan might be calling on some of you. We have a lot of these new flyers ordered, so they'll be going out next week and the week after. So you might be looking at a few volunteers. If you'd like to get your steps up, Ryan's the man for it. So there you go. That would be good. So that's what's happening this week. So everything, most things are back this week. Pilates is back. If you wish to be involved in the Pilates, if you're ready, do it. That's fine. Nicola will have given you information. But if you want, please speak to me afterwards and I'll give you Nicola's details. There's no Thursday night class at the moment. Just she has other commitments that night. But Pilates is back on Tuesdays and on Wednesdays. There's two classes on Wednesday morning. There's no threads this week, just to work commitments. A couple of people have to work this week, but the drop-in's back on. So if you're involved in any of those things, please, please make sure you get along to them. Also, the Tots and Co, we have a playgroup for preschool on Thursday mornings at 10 a.m. down in the hall. So if you've anybody who you think fits in that age bracket, please pop along to that as well. Now, the other thing to look forward to is harvest is coming up on the first of August. I'm still in holiday mode. On the first of October. I'm so glad we're getting a break. First of October, so we are away from Tuesday, and Ryan's going to be looking after the parish for a couple of weeks. I wasn't expecting this big man to be back this morning. He loves you all so much, he came back early from Dublin just to see you. Ryan has started into his final year of his ordination training. The good news is, well, it's good news for some of us, maybe bad news, but Ryan will stay with us for a while whenever he's ordained, so that'll be wonderful. I don't know if that's a good thing or not. If you're visiting with us this morning for the first time, despite appearances, we are quite relaxed in here, so you are very welcome as well. Now, also, just to keep you posted about our big breakfast is coming up for charity. I'm just going to go to it. Yep, there, for the Cancer Fund for Children, Saturday the 7th of October. So if you can help in any way at all, will you please actually speak to Wilma? I'm sure she'd be delighted to have your name. That's actually my breakfast from the last big breakfast. Looks good, doesn't it? No? Very healthy. Exactly, it's very healthy, full of protein. So anyway, that's my big breakfast. So if you can, all the profits from all the funds from that will go to the Cancer Fund. It's the nominated charity for the Mayor of Lisburn and Castlereagh Council. So he will be looking after that. I don't see, is Salwyn in with us this morning, or is he recovering? He's recovering. A great night last night by all reports. So I want to thank everybody who has supported Salwyn in his summer concert series. You can still support him if you want to give a donation towards that. The money is going towards the music fund to be able to bring you more concerts here in the church. So please, please do that. But we want to thank everybody who helped out with that. Now, this morning we are continuing with our series of recognising things, and today we're going to look at recognising prayer and what prayer actually is and how we can do it. So when we come to it, we hope you will understand it. Boys and girls are in with us this morning. It's our family communion service. Next week, Sunday school's back and youth club's back this week as well. So you've all that to look forward to. But I'm sure, boys and girls, you look forward to sitting in church for the whole service, like some of the adults have to. But we hope and pray you will enjoy it. When it comes to communion this morning, we do have one cup for the wine. Now, there's a number of things can happen when you come to the communion rail. We've been using one chalice just at the past couple of half nine services. If you're not comfortable with drinking out of the one cup, there are little individual plastic cups on the way in or at the door. You can bring one of those with you to the communion rail, in which then you can receive a little bit of wine in that if you wish. However, we will be using the one chalice, or simply you can just receive the bread if you're happy with that, and then when it comes round to the cup, we can just simply pass by. Is that pretty clear? Now, this may change, but at the moment, the Church of Ireland policy now is to move to one cup for communion. But we have those other little bits and pieces in there just to keep everybody else happy as well. I think that's most of the announcements. Sorry for dragging on a wee bit this morning, but it's important just to get those things out there to you. I want to just take a moment and pray. I want to pray the collect for today, and then we're going to stand to sing our first hymn, Morning Has Broken. Let us pray. Almighty God, whose only Son has opened for us a new and living way into your presence, give us pure hearts and steadfast wills to worship you in spirit and truth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Will you please stand as we praise God by singing Morning Has Broken.
Morning has broken like the first morning. Blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise from the springing, fresh from the word. Sweet the rains you brought, sounded from heaven, like the first dewfall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the wet garden, sprung in completeness where his feet pass. Mine is a sunlight, mine is a morning, born of the one life, Eden so plain. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new day.
You may be seated. Part of our worship involves coming before God and asking him for his forgiveness. And as we will learn in a moment, when it comes to prayer and how we pray and why we should pray, we will see that little line in the Lord's Prayer that we forgive others just as he has forgiven us. But it's a good way to do it at the start of this worship together, that we come, that we think of perhaps things that we have done wrong recently, or just to re-encounter God in a new and a beautiful way. And we use the words of this prayer. It's from the confession prayer in the communion service in the prayer book. And so we're just going to take a moment of silence. Actually, I'd like to say at the start, If you've wandered away from God, this is a wonderful prayer to come back to Him, to ask Him to take complete control in your life. Or perhaps if you do not have a faith in Christ, it's also a great prayer to be able to commit your life to Him. So we're going to just take a moment, and then we're going to pray these words together. And so we pray, Almighty God. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned in thought and word and deed, and in what we have left undone. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may walk in newness of life to the glory of your name. Amen. Amen. And Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy on you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in everlasting life. Amen. Amen. We are just going to have our first Bible reading now. Yep, excellent. Our first Bible reading.
This morning's reading is Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you, Valerie, for bringing us our first Bible reading. Our Bible readings this morning differ slightly from what would be the set readings for today, but hopefully that will all become clear as we move through the service together. But just that psalm is a wonderful psalm, and even for our young people and our children who are here this morning, that's a great psalm to hold on to. Whenever you're maybe struggling a wee bit, who's struggling and they're only back at school? Teachers. I love the teachers with their hands up as well. But anyway, it's a wonderful psalm that can give us strength as we look at God's creation, as we marvel at it. It's just wonderful to think that God, the God who created that, is the one who is with us and who gives us strength. And so to that end, we have each week we've been having a slightly different praise song, and so we have one that we've sang already. It's Everlasting God, and its strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. So we're going to ask you to stand as we sing this song together. So we'll please stand.
We will wait upon the Lord.
That's a tremendous song that talks about the everlasting God, about lifting us up on wings like eagles. And if you've noticed, when you come into an Anglican church or a Church of Ireland church, can anybody see an eagle in the church? Can anybody see where there's an eagle? Hello. Anybody? Look, adults, I'm trying to talk to children here, okay? But there's an eagle here, right here. Just, if you've noticed it, can you see it? Okay, because it's lifting up God's word, and that's the thing that gives us all strength. It's God's word in our life. And so we're going to have our second Bible reading now from God's word.
The second reading is taken from Luke chapter 11. One day Jesus was praying in a certain place. When he finished, one of his disciples said to him, "Lord, teach us to pray, just as John taught his disciples." He said to them, "When you pray, say, 'Father, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come. Give us each day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, for we also forgive everyone who sins against us, and lead us not into temptation.' Then Jesus said to them, 'Suppose you had a friend, and you go to him at midnight and say, "Friend, lend me 3 loaves of bread. A friend of mine on a journey has come to me, and I have no food to offer him." And suppose the one inside answers, "Don't bother me. The door is already locked, and my children and I are in bed. I can't get up and give you anything." I tell you, even though he will not get up and give you bread because of friendship, yet because of your shameless audacity, he will surely get up and give you as much as you need. So I say to you, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock the door and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives. The one who seeks finds. And to the one who knocks the door will be opened. Which of you fathers, if your son asks for a fish, will give him a snake instead? Or if he asks for an egg, will give him a scorpion? If you then, though you are evil, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your Father in heaven give the Holy Spirit to those who ask for him?" This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thank you, Leslie, for bringing us that portion of Scripture. This is our parish communion service, and as such, we will be using elements from the prayer book. So in just a moment, I will ask you, the words will be on the screen, but if you wish to follow it, you can also follow us, the Creed, on page 205. It's the green books in your pews, but the words will also be on the screen. And just by way of explanation of what a creed is, we're getting back into the new season where we'll be sharing in this service together. It's really a statement of our faith. It's what we believe in, and it gives us all the strength and knowledge of who Jesus is and what he has done for us and what God the Father has bestowed upon us. So we're going to stand together and we're going to affirm our faith in the words of the Nicene Creed. Will you please stand? We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. I'm going to ask you to remain standing as we wait on you now for your tithes and offerings as we sing this lovely song, My Heart is Filled with Thankfulness. So, Lord, as we come to hear from your word, Lord, that gives us strength, Lord, we pray, Lord, that we may have our ears and our hearts open to receive from you. Amen. Amen. Now, I know this is quite a formal slide. It says the sermon, a sermon by me, the rector, but really today's talk, because everybody's in with us, the young and the old, and those who try to stay awake, what we're going to try and do is keep it pretty simple. It's probably like every week really, isn't it? But we want to keep this simple as we look at recognizing prayer and what prayer means to you and what prayer means to me and what prayer especially means to our young people, all the way up through to the oldest person in this room. And some of us have different ideas of what prayer is and what prayer looks like. And so I pinched this cartoon this week. It may take you a wee while to figure out what it actually is doing. Alright. Does anybody get my sense of humour? Right, okay. So what you see there, what animal is it?
Walrus,
okay. And it says, after last week's incident, I've decided we will no longer bow our heads to pray. Alright? Because some of us have sort of that thing about prayer that it can only be done in certain ways. or at certain times. It can only be done when we come to church. But what I want to do this morning is to maybe make you think about prayer in a slightly different way. And as, who remembers Sesame Street? Is it still a thing? Yes, young people said it's still a thing. Adults are going, no, it's not. But guess what? It's still a thing. So today's service is going to be brought to you by the number what?
Five.
You're all still with me, okay? It's going to be brought to you by the number five. Now, on your colouring sheets, if you've got one and you present it at the end of the service, you know what happens. You get a bag of sweets. If you haven't got one, what I would suggest is that somehow you try to get out the foyer and grab one. But anyway, today, I want to encourage you to think about prayer in as five things, okay? So, don't worry. It's not 5 points, very long points, but it's five short things that hopefully will help you. Now, this week, I got away on Monday to get my head cleared a wee bit. I got myself down to a beach in County Down. I'd like to say I was going for a run, but if you saw me, you probably would be going for the defib or something like that. But just sometimes it's good to get away. And Jesus, in one of his other passages of scripture, says sometimes it's good to lock yourself away to spend time in prayer with him. And we know through Jesus' example that even when it came to the time whenever he was to be crucified, it says he went away to a place to pray by himself. So I got away on Monday. I got down to a beach and I got to run along a beach. But the reason I've got Psalm 121 in, if you know, it's probably along with a few of the other Psalms, Psalm 91 and a few others. It's one of my favourites. But as I struggled along that beach, and as I struggled physically and perhaps in my head with some of the things going on that I needed to pray about, I turned at one end of the beach and looked. And what did I see? Did anybody see my video?
The Mourne.
The Mourne Mountains. Just rising up. And actually, the way it was, it looked like they were floating a wee bit because I should have had the photograph up there. There was a wee bit of mist just at the bottom of the Mourne's. And as the beautiful sea, how smooth it was, as I looked towards the Mourne's, I had these words coming to me. I will look up to the hills. From where does my help come from? It doesn't come from those mountains, but it comes from the God who created them. And it was a real sense that God was just... I wish he was carrying me along that beach. You know that wee thing, footsteps? I wish that was me, but I had to run back again. But I had a real sense that I wanted to talk to the church this morning about the importance of prayer. For a lot of you began a new season at school. For some of you, it's maybe a tough season ahead where you've got exams. For some of our P7s, whether you do a selection or not, it can be a worrying few weeks and months. But for the rest of us in here, we're probably at different stages in our lives whenever it's important to think about prayer. So the first things I want to talk to you about are the five W's. Okay? I wonder, can anybody guess the five W's of prayer? It's not wailing. Wailing's not in it. No? Okay. But the five W's begin with this, and it's how we can pray. It's who can pray. Who do you think can pray?
Everyone.
Not just Ryan or myself or the people that come to the prayer meetings, but everyone can pray. No matter what age you are, everyone can pray. What can we pray for? Anybody? Good looks hasn't worked for some of us. A slim body definitely hasn't worked. Well, actually, do you know what? What can we pray for? Tom? Anything. We can pray for anything. Jesus tells us in that passage when he's teaching his disciples to pray, he says, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock on the door will be opened. I'm just going to digress a wee bit on that one. And the door will be opened. Sometimes we pray, and we pray for things that we never get real answers to. Sometimes we pray and we get a partial answer, and sometimes we pray and we get the answer, and sometimes more than we could ever have imagined. But it all begins with this: what we pray for. We can pray for anything. Right, this is a good one. When do we pray? Anybody? Tom, again, you can only get 2 questions. But what? Anytime. Okay. Have you guessed that the answers to the W's are begin with A? Anytime. We can pray at any time. Not just, you don't have to come to church just to pray. Although I would like to say you get special prayers when you come here to encourage more people, but you can pray at any time. When I was a wee boy, I only thought you had to pray at bedtime before you get into bed. When your mum and dad sat you down by the side of your bed, or you kneeled down, and that was the only time you prayed. But you can pray at any time. I always remember hearing an old pastor tell us about praying in the car, but he says, make sure you keep your eyes open. That's a good one, isn't it? But we can pray at any time. And this is what I have found most beneficial. And when training for ministry and going into ordination, was the idea of constant prayer. And so boys and girls and anybody, when you're walking to school or when you're getting a lift to school, you can pray. You don't have to close your eyes. You can keep your eyes open. And sometimes it's good if you can get yourself to a place that you love. Scenery is always good. It aids you in your prayer. Right. Where? Just anywhere. Pray anywhere. It doesn't matter where you are. In the bath. Actually, do I do most of my showering? Praying. In the shower. It's a great spot. Sometimes Rosie says, who are you talking to? I would like to say some of the times I'm very holy and I'm talking to God, but other times I'm just rambling or singing. But anyway, pray anywhere. All right? Sometimes it's important to pray 2 minutes before the exam that you haven't studied for, in the hope that you get some sort of divine inspiration. But pray anywhere. And importantly, this has got an A as well. Why should we pray? Jesus has already told us in this passage. Answers. Because we get answers. Now, as I've said, sometimes you don't necessarily get the answer we were hoping for. But if we don't ask, we don't get. I love a little phrase. There's a two-word phrase in that passage in Luke. And Jesus uses it. Well, the translator has translated it as best he could. And he talks about shameless audacity. He talks about somebody going to somebody's house late at night and asking for bread. What would you do if somebody came to your house asking for bread late at night? You can guess what would happen in our house if somebody knocked the door at 1 or 2 in the morning. Okay, they'd find themselves face down and probably fisticuffed or whatever it is on the ground. But what happens? Jesus says because of the persistence of that person, they get what they ask for. The audacity of prayer. I should have had that as the title this morning. But the shameless audacity of actually asking God for all things. Never underestimate the power of it. And so, how is important? Now, I love this. Hopefully this kind of comes out. Boys and girls in school, have you heard of the five-fingered prayer? It's actually wrong because there's a thumb in there, but go with me. Five-fingered prayer. Has anybody heard of it? Some of you? Anybody want to come up and demonstrate it? Toby? No? No? Maybe not. Right, okay. So, this is a quick guide. A very easy guide. If you don't know what to pray for, sometimes when you go to pray, you go, oh, my head's completely blank. This, right, what we're going to do, we do a wee thing in the youth club, or sometimes we do it in Genesis. We stretch ourselves out, okay, we get ready, right, don't be slapping the person beside you. If you can, put your arms out like that. I was going to say run around the church and pretend you're an airplane, but no, that's a different sermon. And then you bring your hands together, okay? And you do that, right? Keep your hands like that, okay? So, this is how it goes, if I remember right, okay? So, I think that's a wee bit small, the print's a wee bit small, but when we go to pray, okay, the thumb, it's the one that's closest to your heart, isn't it? Think about it. The thumb is closest to your heart. So we pray for those we are close to. We pray for our mums and our dads, our brothers. I know it's difficult, and our sisters. We pray, and we pray for the ones that we love. Okay? This finger, what's this one? It's the pointy finger, isn't it? You use it to point. So when we come to that, we pray for those who lead us. We pray for those who give us instructions. We pray for those who teach us. How many young people pray for their teachers? In one way or another. But we pray for those who teach us. Next one, okay? We pray for, this is the tallest finger. We pray, the tallest finger represents the leaders of our land. They need a lot of prayer. We pray for the leaders in our land, for those in authority over us, those in government, those in business, and those in our schools, and those in society. We pray for our leaders. Now, I didn't know this until I looked this up, but the next finger, okay, this one, this is your ring finger. If you're married, sometimes you put your rings on it, okay? Or if you're like me, when you put your wedding ring on it and then you get old and a wee bit heavier, the wedding ring doesn't come back off. But I didn't know this. Maybe some of the physios or some of the OTs in the countries, it's the weakest finger. It's one of our weakest fingers. So we remember those who are weak and vulnerable, those who are sick, and those who are ill. That's the easiest way. So we go from the thumb, what do they say? Those closest to us. For those who give us instructions in life, for those who are in government or authority, the next one for the weakest, for those who are sick, those who are ill, and then the little pinky. What do you think that one's for? The last finger. The last finger is for yourself. Because we need to remember it's the smallest one, and as we pray, it's important to place others before us. I heard this years ago, and what I used to do was pray for mommy, daddy, everybody else, and now, Lord, this is what I want. Anybody else do that? But we are encouraged to pray, and to pray at all times. In a moment, we are going to just have our prayers, and then we're going to share in communion together. And if you're not a member of the church, this is not Church of Ireland table or denominational table. This is the Lord's table, because when Jesus presented the idea of sharing in bread and wine, it was for all who have a faith in him. So you're very welcome to come forward. I want the boys and girls, if you can come forward as well, you can come forward, because there's a special treat for you. My favourites. Anybody? Jelly babies. Okay. So you can come forward as well. But as we think about prayer, as we think about the importance of it, I hope that in that short little talk that you sort of grasp what it is and what it can do for each one of us. And keep your eyes open when you're driving, if you're praying. But it comes down to this, and we'll sing this at the end of the service. One of the other favourite psalms, Psalm 23. The Lord is our shepherd. But the chorus of that says, I will trust in you alone. So the importance of prayer comes down to trusting in God. Let us pray. And so, Lord, we thank you for the simplicity of your word. We thank you that your Son, Jesus Christ, taught us to pray. And as he taught us, Lord, he encouraged us to pray at all times, wherever we are and whatever situation we are in. And so, Lord, in Ballylesson this morning, we come before you, and Lord, we just ask Lord, for your love and your goodness to be in each one of our lives. Lord, we thank you for everybody here. Lord, we thank you for our young people, Lord, and our children, Lord. We thank you for our adults, Lord, and everybody else, Lord, who is with us. And we pray, Lord, that they will experience this morning your presence. And so, Lord, as we think of your presence, Lord, we come before you, Lord, and we pray for those who are in need. Lord, for those who are weak. Lord, for those who need healing in their lives. Lord, we pray especially for those who mourn. Lord, we think of the families tomorrow, Lord, that Ryan and I, Lord, will be ministering to you. Lord, we pray that they will know the comfort that comes from you. And so, Lord, we just pray for the activities in this community, Lord, in our church, Lord, that are happening over the next week and few days, Lord, that you indeed, Lord, will be in the midst of them. And so, Lord, also, as we've been asked to do, Lord, we want to pray and remember Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, Lord, on this, the first anniversary, Lord, of her death. Lord, we pray, Lord, that you will indeed bless the King, Lord, that you will be with his family at this time, Lord, as they continue to mourn the loss of a loved one. And so, Lord, we just pray for the week ahead. Lord, whatever that may entail for each one of us, Lord, we pray for your presence to be known in all of our lives. And so, Lord, as we have heard, Lord, we sum up our prayers in the beautiful words that you taught us as we say together, Our Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Amen. As I said, we're going to move towards our communion service. You can follow these next bits of liturgy on page 216 of the prayer book. I think Ryan's going to just scroll through for us just some of the liturgy here. But as I said, when it comes to, please don't feel under pressure when it comes to receiving the cup. If you've got it in the cup with you, we can put some wine in that. If you don't have a cup with you, just cross your arms after you receive the bread, and we'll understand that. But just let you know, it is fortified wine in a silver cup, so that's what we've always used. We've used for hundreds of years, and so that's what we'll be using in our main part of the communion together. Amen. As I said, we could use just the little order of prayer that can begin on page 216 of the prayer book. I just want to use a little prayer before we use this liturgy. Father, Lord of all creation, we praise you for your goodness and your love. When we turned away, you did not reject us. You came to meet us in your Son, welcomed us as your children, and prepared a table where we might feast with you. In Christ, you shared our life that we might live in him and he in us. And Lord Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, on the night before you died, you came to table with your friends, and taking bread, you gave thanks. You broke it, and you gave it to your disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Lord Jesus, we bless you. You are the bread of life. At the end of supper, you took the cup, and you gave thanks,
and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Lord Jesus, we bless you. You are the bread of life. Indeed, the bread which we break is a sharing in the body of Christ. We, being many, are one body, for we all share in the one bread. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for feeding us with the spiritual gifts of your body and blood. Lord, may we each, Lord, be aware of the sacrifice that you made for each one of us. And so, Lord, may we be blessed by your presence through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. That's just our parish communion. It takes me a bit longer to work through things this morning, so... But I hope you enjoyed your service with us this morning. Now, we're going to close with this beautiful hymn. If you're visiting with us for the first time this morning, please, please, please join us in the hall afterwards. It's a lovely little walk. Thunderstorm hasn't arrived yet. If it arrives halfway down, just run for it. It's the easiest way. If you trip and fall, it's not my fault, by the way. But please do that. We have the best coffee in Ballylesson. We have also the best tea selection as well, so please pop down and join with us. And again, remember, for the next couple of weeks, just pastoral emergencies and care, give Ryan a wee ring. We'll not be able to get to you from where we will be, so Ryan will be here to look after you as well. So we're going to stand, and remember what I said about prayer, about trusting in God. We'll do the coloured in sheets just at the very end, Tom. See this bribery? It works, doesn't it? Maybe if I offered bags of sweets out to the adults, what do you think? Yeah. Helen? Okay, right. We're going to stand and praise God.
The Lord's my shepherd, I'll not want. He makes me lie in pastures green. He leads me by the still, still waters. His goodness restores my soul. And I will trust in you alone. And I will trust in you alone. For your endless mercy follows me. Your goodness will lead me home. He guides my ways in righteousness, and he anoints my head with oil, and my cup it overflows with joy. I feast on his pure delights, and I will trust. For your endless I will not fear the evil one, for you are with me, and your rod and staff are the comfort I need to know. And I will trust in you alone, and I will trust in you alone. For your endless mercy follows me, your goodness will lead me home.
You may be seated for 2 seconds. So who did the collard in shakes? Right, just one, you get the whole bags in. Anybody up there? Right, Toby, up, come quick. Where's the rowdies going? Where are they? They didn't color in, no, they didn't, right, all right, thanks. Right, okay, let me see, hold them up. But you're not for the sweets. Right, guys, what did I say in prayer for brothers and sisters? Right, let me see this first. Oh, look, quite colorful, what do you say? Excellent. That's very good, well done. Right, oh, Tom and Bobby McMurray, you two both, they did what? Right. See these? You need to pray for these children when you get them home. Oh, well done, Toby. Nice. That's it. Right. So, here we go. Right, have a choice. Take one. Right, okay. That's enough. Right, please leave some. Right, John. Let me see. Oh, right. Honest, you're getting one for Poppy. Right, all right. We'll let him off. Right, Hell, here you go. Go on. Is it your birthday or anniversary or something? No. Anybody else? There's not many left. Okay. This has probably been the longest service you've been in for a while, isn't it? Yes. You're supposed to say no, it just went like that. Okay. So may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all this day and forever. Amen. Thank you, Ryan.